heavy. So in these problems, we have the following situation. This is the time. Seconds. And this is the angular velocity in radians per second. It's one of those things that is called. And the angular velocity as a function of time in crankshaft. Then it's constant seconds and goes down from 4 to 7. It's to seconds like that. And you're asked to get the angular velocity, or the angular acceleration. At t equals 1 second, t equals 3 seconds, and t equals 5 seconds. So, note the definition of the angular acceleration is just the change in angular velocity with respect to time. So, this is the slope of this graph. This is the rise over the run. And so, we can just very easily calculate those quantities. So here the delta omega is from 250 minus 50. This is radians per second. And we divide by the time, which is 2 seconds. This is 200 radians per second divided by 2 seconds. That's 100 radians per second. Okay, so I'm going to put that over here. The angular acceleration at 1 second is 100 radians per second. At 3 seconds, well, then we don't have to calculate anything. The rise is zero, so the slope is zero. It's just constant, and so angular acceleration is also zero. And finally, at 5 seconds, we have 100. Radians per second minus the original was radians per second and divide by the time, which is 1, 2, 3 seconds. This is equal to -150 radians per second divided by 3 seconds. So that's going to be 50 radians per second squared. So we have the true values of the angular acceleration. So this is just the same as with the linear velocity, get the acceleration from the slope. Here we get the angular acceleration from the slope of the angular velocity. So the math and the reasoning is exactly the same. Okay, hope you liked it.